Timing is everything, and everything happens for a reason. So I'm just thrilled to death that she said yes and that she would sing this song with me and say yes to doing the video. It's just a dream come true, and I absolutely love the way she sang it.
Country music royalty, Reba McEntire, hello.
Hey, how you doing?
Oh, I am really good. I am so excited that you were doing this. Thank you. What a joy, what a pleasure.
Well, my pleasure also. Good to talk to you. I appreciate it.
So, Reba, this brand new triple album, are we calling it a box set? It's a box set, revived, remixed, revisited. It's out now. It's quite something. So what made you release this now?
Well, it's kind of a box set, but I've done box sets before. And what it is, we just put out the songs that we recorded and kind of repackage them. This has totally been redone. The revived is 10 songs that the band and I went back into the studio, recorded the songs as we performed them on stage at a concert. So that's different. And then the remix is dance mixes. And then revisited is the songs that we went into the studio with Dave Cobb and recorded, stripped down version, a little laid back, a little slower. And so all the songs on each album, all three albums, they're different than the way the fans have heard them originally.
Yes. So the revived bit of it, do those songs change over time when you're out performing them on the road? Like doing them in front of an audience and kind of doing them night after night, do they affect how you end up interpreting that song?
I think so. When we record them in the studio from the first time, we use a fade out on this song. Well, you can't do that in a live performance, so you have to have an ending. So, and then some of the songs have a different intro, longer, or maybe it's the beginning of the show, the concert. And so it's a bigger production for the intro. So that's also what is on the album, Revived.
Now, I see that you're going to be back in Las Vegas this winter with Reba, Brooks, and Dunn together in Vegas. And I read it's the longest running country residence in Las Vegas. Just how long have you been doing it at Caesar's Palace?
We started in 2015 and we missed a year because of COVID. 2 years, 2020 and 2021. So we're looking forward to going back in December. This will be our last engagement there, our last trip. Yeah, but you never know about old Ronnie and Kix and me. You never know where we'll be showing up, turn together somewhere down the road.
Yeah, because you've toured together for ages, right? Before Vegas.
Yeah. Yeah. We toured together in the 90s and then they got back together and we went to Vegas and had fun. Vegas is a wonderful place to perform. I absolutely love it.
Lots of sequins, more sequins than normal.
Oh, yeah. Razzle dazzle.
Razzle dazzle. Absolutely. So with everything kind of thankfully now opening up again with international travel, other than the razzle dazzle and some great songs, is there some extra kind of pizzazz in the Vegas show that people can expect when they come over and see you in that residency?
Well, yeah. Please come over. And I am so glad things are opening up where y'all can come over and see us because we miss you. With our show in Vegas, Ronnie and Kix and I, we share the stage. We have fun coming in, coming out. So it's not like one group is on together by themselves and then the other group comes on. It's different than any other concert we do separately. So we love to tour together.
Excellent. Well, I cannot wait because I love a Vegas show. You know, you never know. Are they going to be underwater? Are they going to be on a trapeze? You just never know. We'll have to wait and see.
Absolutely.
So you're going out in the new year with some more dates across the U.S. as well. And I love this, Reba, because joining you on this tour are some really great names who just happen to be female. We've got Brandi Clark, Kaylee Hammock, who I absolutely love, Raina Roberts, who just brings it home every time, Caitlin Smith, Brittany Spencer, who is blowing up all over the place right now, and Tennille Towns, who we love as well. So this was obviously a choice, right? You're saying, hey, we're going to support these up and coming female artists and put them on a platform.
Yeah. And what's really fun is that each lady will take a weekend. It would be fun if all of them were together on each weekend, but like Brandi will do one weekend and then Kaylee will do the next weekend. And it's a great way for me to get to know, meet some of these ladies I've never even met before. Right. So I really want to know who's in the business, who's our up and coming. So it's just given me a more chance to be educated about their career and what they're doing.
Yeah, it's fantastic. And they're all absolutely wonderful. And walking on that road that you paved, Reba. So fantastic that you're giving them a platform.
You're sweet to say that.
So in, I think it was 2017 when you were over here for Country to Country, and you were absolutely iconic. I was very privileged to be side of stage watching you. And there was a moment where you were just at the front of the stage and you were just in your element. One of our listeners, Daniel, messaged the show and he asked a question that we all want to know is, when are we going to see you back in the UK?
Oh, I hope soon. I do love to come to the UK to perform, to visit, vacation, whatever. The hospitality you always show us, it's just warming. I absolutely love to come to the UK. So hopefully very soon.
Fingers crossed. Allison also got in touch with the show. And this is a great question, I think. What's your favorite song to close a show with?
Always Fancy. I never close a show without Fancy.
You know what? I knew the answer to that, but I was like, I'm going to let Reba tell it. Because you got to make them wait for Fancy.
Yeah.
Many moons ago when I waited tables in New York City, before we would open the restaurant every single day, the staff would put on Fancy and we would dance around like there was nobody watching and just have a great old time. And so I'm so pleased that it is on this new project of yours. Why is this song so important to you, though? I know why it's so important to me, but why is it important to you?
Phelan, you could have led with that. I had no idea. I wish I had a video of you guys dancing before the doors open. That's great.
Oh, we loved it. It really got us in the mood, you know, it's like, because sometimes you're dragging yourself into work and you think, oh, I really don't want to do this today. And we all knew if we put on Fancy, we're going to feel fine by the time we open those doors.
Oh my gosh, I love it. Well, I've been a huge fan of Fancy since Bobby Gentry recorded it in 1968 and had a number one hit with it. It's a rags to riches story song I just love. And I've been singing it forever and then re-recorded it in 1990. And I sing it on every show because I just love it. I become Fancy Ray Baker when I sing Fancy.
And you know what? You ain't alone, because a lot of us become Fancy Ray Baker when we play Fancy. Now, before you go, we have to talk about your good friend, Dolly Parton. We just had her on the show. I think it was last month, one of the highlights until today, another highlight happening with you. You, Reba, you've won 6 CMA Awards, 3 Grammys. You've had 35 number one singles. You've sold over 56 million albums, and you've only just got around to recording a duet with your good friend Dolly. What took you so long?
That's what she and I would talk about when we were shooting the video. We didn't get to be together when we recorded the song because of COVID. But when we were sitting around waiting for the cameras to move around and change the lights, we were sitting there just shaking our heads. You know, why is it taking so long? But timing is everything and everything happens for a reason. So I'm just thrilled to death that she said yes and that she would sing this song with me and say yes to doing the video. It's just a dream come true. And I absolutely love the way she sang it, her interpretation of it. And so I asked her, I said, what made you change it up from the way Linda sang it? She said, I just sing the way I feel it.
I mean, that's one of the things that makes her so special, makes you so special. And then putting it together, you know, it's just like an overload of specialness. And also this song has such a place in so many people's lives. And then to hear it not only come back, but then, you know, with you doing it with added Dolly, so special. So what's it like when you two get together? And what is it about Dolly that is so special for you?
To me, Dolly is so witty, so warm, so approachable. She's just like a girlfriend. I mean, like your buddy. And she, on our Living and Learning podcast, she was giving us these one-liners, these hysterical, what she comes up with is so funny, so witty, so smart. I just totally enjoyed visiting with her. She's an incredible woman. She's done so much in her life, but if you just sat and talked to her, you would never know all of the things she's done and the accolades. You'd never learn that from her. You would just know that you're talking to a very warm, loving person.
She's just good people. She is raised right.
She is. You bet. She is raised right.
Reba, thank you so much for talking to us. It's been such a joy to spend some time with you.
Oh, well, thank you very much for letting me visit with you. And I want to say a big hi to everyone there in the UK. Thanks again for all the hospitality you showed me and my group the last time we were there. And hopefully we get to come back and see you all again real soon.
Absolute Radio Country.